called it Seclusion Squats. So hopefully you enjoy it. There's a few things we're doing differently. Number one is we're going back to two different sets here. We're going to go through four rounds of each set, but our repetitions are going to scale. So we're going to start with 10 reps in round one, then go to 8, then go to 5, then go to 3, then we'll take a break. We'll go down to the bottom and do the same thing, 10, 8, 5, 3. So we want you to pick a little bit heavier weight. Obviously in 10 reps, it's going to be the hardest round that we have, so anticipate the biggest challenge on that first round. Jane and I are each going to use a 20-pound weight as we work through these. We're also looking for an elevated heart rate today, so we're going to try to give you a quick overview of the exercises, but we want to get moving right away. So you might want a mat. You are definitely going to want a resistance or a dumbbell. If you're using a resistance band, you're going to want to attach it low to something to provide your resistance. There might be a couple exercises you can't use anything, so if you have a water bottle jug, a small dog, whatever it is, grab onto that too. We're doing an elevated glute bridge, so with that you either need a wall or a bench or a chair or something. So as long as you have all of those things, you're ready to start the first round. If you don't, hit pause and come back. But if you do, our first exercise is a squat and an RDL. So you're going to hold that weight. We'll do one squat, and then we're going to get our balance for one RDL. We're going to do 5 RDLs on one leg, then we'll switch our hands, and we'll squat an RDL on the other leg for 5, getting 10 reps total. Then goblet squat, we'll hold that weight at our chest, doing our squats. Then for the Bulgarian twist, you have two choices. Either if you have a lighter weight because that's all you have, you hold that weight extended out in front of you, or if you're not using a weight at all, hold it out in front of you as you do your twist. So you'll be down at the bottom of your Bulgarian, twist to the side, and come right back up, all right? If you're holding a heavy weight, you're gonna keep it at your chest. So the same thing, at our chest, we'll go low, into that twist, come back up. And then elevated glute bridge, we're going to hold that weight on our hips as we do them with our feet either up on the bench or the wall, and then a burpee. Luckily the burpee has no weight. We're going to show you a bunch of modifications for that, either with our hands on the bench, couch, or chair, or an easier step in for less impact. We'll not be doing a jump at the top of the burpees. We're just going to work in through the hop out, hop in, standing up all the way around with a push-up. Okay? All right, so 10 reps on the first round. Grab your heavy weight. And we've got squat and RDL. So for the RDL portion, you're gonna hold, you'll be on the leg opposite the weight in the hand. All right, here we go. So you'll notice Jane taking a little bit wider squat stance. That's completely fine. You've gotta do what feels comfortable you. Switching sides. Sometimes it's more comfortable to be wider and letting that weight pass between your legs. Good. That's 5, right? Yeah. Jane, you're the counter. Goblet squats, but there are a ton of them here. Make sure you get that nice upright posture every time. Stable. Good. All right, we've got elevated glute bridges next. So to the wall, to your bench, whatever you choose to use. I'll try to show you guys a side view here. Rest that weight right on your hips. We've got a ton of these. Pushing up, lock those glutes. Extend your hips through. Make sure you hold on to that weight so it doesn't roll down and hit you in the face. more for me. Cool. Good, down to the ground. Got your elevated glute bridges. Remember that you're focusing this work on your glutes. Keep your core nice and tight. Don't try to lift from your back, lift from your hips. Eight of these guys, make sure we pause at the top. Glutes are tight. Squats, five total. That rotation happening right through that belly button. Glute bridges. Five total. Make sure you hit that pause at the top every time. Focus on those glutes. Five burpees. Here we go. Seconds. All right, three, goblet squats. Bulgarian twist. Three aside. Elevated glute bridges. Aren't these threes nice?
Make sure you hit that big pause. Feel those glutes turn on at the top every time. Good work.
And three burpees. Here we go. Two more for my count.
And one more for me.
Good work. We've got our sumo squats. 10 of these guys. Keep that core tight. Try and get a nice deep range of motion. Really get those hips to bring you to the top and through. Knees pointing in the direction of your toes. Good. Reverse lunge and twist. So again, you don't have any weight. Arms stay straight the whole time. You have that weight. Keep it right in next to that that chest. Focusing on turning our shoulders towards the opposite wall. Stability at both hips. Really pulling up through that front leg. This is 10?
Yeah.
Good. Switching sides. Work hard to anchor yourself in that front leg. Halfway. Remember, you're getting the worst of every round done. All right, single leg glute bridges. So if you want to use the wall or your chair still, take a look at Jade. If you're down on the floor, you're with me here. 10 aside. We're just trying to lift, squeezing that glute. I have such a huge disparity when I go to single leg that it's not really good for me to elevate to a bench right now without being able to produce more movement on this angle. Two more. Make sure that you squeeze every time, feeling those glutes. Even if your motion is small, keep that back super still. Try and keep your pelvis level with the ground. Don't let one hip drop or raise up more. Drive that heel through the ground. A little pause at the top each time, feeling that glute. We have one more. Good. All right, lunge switches. All right, so Jade's got the full version. I've got your modification here. The idea is that you're jumping from a lunge position to the other foot forward in the lunge position. So that's what Jade's got here. We're stepping back with me. Just quick switching of the feet. Try to make a little bit of a moment where you have your feet moving off the ground at the same time. 3, 2, and break. Good. Little 30-second break here, and we're back to the top on squat and side lunge, but only for 8. So we've got 4 aside this time. Moving in the right direction, guys. After you get that first round done, everything starts to go faster. Really fast after the first 2 rounds, because your last 2 total, the second round. It's pretty great. All right, so hopefully your heart rate is elevated. Take some deep, clearing breaths. Really try to control your breathing, especially during these resistance-based exercises. Nice and smooth, nice and calm, so that when you get to that finisher, in this case, the lunge switches, as your heart rate goes up, you can bring it right back down. All right, here we go, squat and side lunge. 4 aside. Loading into that glute of the bending leg. And break. Sumos here, 8 of them. Nice full range of motion. Use those hips. That chest nice and upright, core is tight. And break, good. Reverse lunge and twist. Remember, you're twisting over or away from the front leg. No weight, arms are out. Three more. Switching legs. Here we go. You guys are over halfway as we finish this round. Well over halfway. Good work. Down to the ground. Single leg glute bridges. 8 aside. Remember, we're focusing on that glute, lifting us up. Keep your core tight. That leg nice and stable that's on the ground.
Don't let the knee wobble in and out. Lunge switches. So if what the modification I showed you wasn't quite enough, we'll give you another one here. Ready? Here we go, 20 of them. So these we're just gonna make smaller. We're gonna go for the entire time that Jane's going as she gets to 16. Because ours are smaller, we'll probably do more. Just a lesser impact, a little bit of a jump, but not quite as deep. Okay. Back to the top. Catch our breath here for about 30 seconds. And you're on the squat and RDL. So if you really feel like those lunge switches, modifications aren't giving you enough of a heart rate increase out of it, keep duomoon. Just do more. Double your reps. Your heart rate will go up for sure. Try to speed up the reps. Your heart rate will go up for sure. Okay. So we're on five, but with this exercise, we do three a side, just because we've got some single side movements here. Squat and lunge. Good, sumo squats. Reverse lunges. Oops. Away from the front leg. Five aside here. Switching on mine. Working here, guys. Doing great. All right. Single leg bridges. Five a leg. Really hit that high point, guys. Really make sure that those glutes are engaged. Make sure that your hips are staying level. Pause for just a second each time. Control your breathing. Keep that upper body nice and still. Awesome. We've got lunge switches. So, five a leg here. Here we go.
Nine, ten.
Woo! One more round. Best news ever. A little shorter break here. Bring that heart rate down. Try and control your inhale and your exhale. Five more seconds. So, first exercise is two aside. Just keeping it even. Here we go. This round's gonna fly by, guys. Really work for that nice full range of motion. One by one, sumo squats. Got your reverse lunges. Away from the front leg. Three aside. All right, single leg glute bridges. Three side here. Really focusing on that glute engagement. Don't rush the reps, keep that core tight so we don't get any excessive arching. Good. Last one. Three lunge switches aside. Here we go.
Six.
You're done. All right, guys, so a little change up for this week. So
something a little different with our rep count. Hopefully you guys feel that heart rate impact today, and we'll see you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye.